Welcome to the last day of competition here at the 29th Summer Universiade in Taipei. There was only one more competition to wrap up, and that was the men's water polo finals. This gold medal matchup was between Serbia and Russia. Serbia took the first possession of this game, and they showed their dominance and patience early on. Passing the ball around the top, they find the middle man, and Vico slings it into the back of the net for Serbia to take the first lead, 1-0. They would quickly move to 2-0, and now they're back on the offensive. Rasovic slings it in from deep, making that one look easy. Serbia now up 3-0, but it wouldn't be long until they scored one more, sitting at 4-0. But Russia trying to get it in. A beautiful shot goes off the crossbar and in for Kharkov of Russia. They put Russia now on the board. Moving forward, it's 10-3 for Serbia. Both teams now on the move. Subotic picks it up out of nowhere, throws it in, and brings Serbia's lead now 11-3. Russia scores one more, but Serbia's not done yet. Radojevic, a couple fakes, a little shimmy, and it's good, extending Serbia's lead and really showing that huge dominance they have in this game. It's now 13-4. Now on the power play, Vico looking to get one more. Same play, they find him right in the middle. He keeps that ball high and out of the water, goes underwater himself, and then pushes forward, and it's good. Russia takes that needed time out because there's only about a minute left in the matchup. 1:15 on the clock, great stop. Who will get the rebound though? Radojevic once again, a little shimmy up top, and he shows why he continues with that move, because it's successful. Look at this, he pops up out of the water, off the bounce, right over the goaltender of Russia. And even in the dying seconds, Russia tries to get one more shot. It looked good off the crossbar, won't be successful. And with that, Serbia wins the gold medal in the water polo men's final. Look at this. They want everyone in the water with them. Bring their coach in there with his clothes on and everything. It was a celebration for Serbia as they won the gold medal. Hoping this is a waterproof phone, but it's going to be one of the best selfies here at the Universiade. Serbia win the gold medal once again. The silver medal goes to Russia, of course, and the bronze is earned by Team Italy. With Serbia's victory, that wraps up all competition here at the 2017 Summer Universiade. The only thing left for these athletes now was the closing ceremony tonight. Just a few hours after water polo, it was time for the closing ceremony of the 29th Summer Universiade in Taipei. This one took place in the Taipei Stadium, right in the heart of Taipei City.
Ladies and gentlemen, the closing ceremony of the 29th Summer Universiade 2017 Taipei will now begin.
Throughout the last 2 weeks, there was over 7,500 athletes from 141 countries who competed in 21 sports throughout this Universiade. And at the end of it all, it was Japan that led the medal table with 101 total medals, including 37 golds. They won 10 of those gold medals in judo, 9 in swimming, and 7 in athletics, and many, many more. The Republic of Korea ended up in second in the medal table, earning a total of 30 gold medals. And smaller delegations like Kyrgyzstan, who brought 7 athletes, and Jamaica, who brought 13 athletes, they each went home with a gold medal as well. And as a sold-out Taipei arena, listen to the Chinese Taipei anthem. They got ready to welcome all 7,000 and some athletes into the arena. These games began on August 18th, and since then, almost 300 medals have been earned from athletes from all over the world. One of the best parts of the closing ceremonies is that the athletes all march the stadium unified as one. Most of the athletes have been living in the Athletes Village together for 2 weeks now and have made friends with athletes from every single continent that's represented here. The World University Games are the second largest multi-sport international event in the entire world, only sitting behind the Olympic Games. With 141 countries represented here, this is the largest multi-sport event ever hosted in Taipei City. There's Taiwan's vice president on the left, Taipei City mayor, and his wife, watching the athletes march through Taipei Arena.
Hong Kong, China.
Hong Kong, China. 匈牙利.
Hungary.
Hungary.
Indo. India.
And
Italy.
FISU president Oleg Matitsin gives a wave to all the athletes down underneath. It would take about an hour for all these athletes to make their way all the way around, and athletes from all over the world. You're looking at athletes from Colombia there, Italy in there behind them, Algeria, Belarus, Ethiopia, Germany, and more. Throughout the university, this stadium hosted the athletics event, and it wrapped up 2 days ago with the men's 4x400 meter relay race. That one was won by the Dominican Republic. At capacity, this arena holds 21,000 people, and tonight it is a sold-out event. And even at 7:30 at night, it's still over 30 degrees Celsius outside here in Sangshan District of Taipei City. During these ceremonies, over 18,000 volunteers are helping with the event in the stadium and all throughout the city to help fans, visitors, and athletes have a good time. Here's the Swiss team waving to the camera. Now Russia gets some time in the spotlight. They ended this Universiade with 25 goals. The Japanese athletes now saying hello. They're all smiles after coming in first in the medal table. And talk about smiles, the hometown Chinese Taipei athlete. They finished in the medal table with 26 golds, including men's 10-meter sprint, the men's javelin event, badminton, billiards, gymnastics, taekwondo, tennis, weightlifting, wushu, and a whopping 10 gold medals in the roller sports event. The first cultural performance tonight at the closing ceremony was entitled Taipei Loves You, and it was Aboriginal singer Jia Jia who sang the praise of the heroes who made these dreams come true. And as the band arrives into the stadium, it's 100 birds overhead that signify courage. This flock of birds will help lead the ship to land and touch down in Taipei City. Here comes the boat now. And on that boat, it's Taiwan's own indie band, Fire X. Aboriginal singer Jia Jia joined Fire X on the stage as traditional and modern came together for a once-in-a-lifetime performance. And after the first performance came to an end, it was time for the official ceremony to get underway. It was Taiwan's Vice President Chen Qianzhen who delivered the first speech.
On the first evening, President Tsai said, she hopes the people of Taiwan would put our best foot forward for the world to see. For all fellow citizens, we did it. Again, thank you, President Mathiesen, for your support, and thank you, Mayor Cole, for a successful event.
谢谢大家，我们做到了。祝大家平安喜乐。
We did it. I wish everyone continued peace and happiness. Thank you, everybody.
Next to the podium was the chair of the 2017 Summer Universiade Executive Committee and Taipei Mayor Ke Wen-je and FISU President Oleg Mathiesen.
And Mayor of Taipei, Mr. Ke Wen-je, and President of the International University Sports Federation, Mr. Oleg Mathiesen.
Mesdames, Messieurs, veuillez accueillir le président du comité d'organisation de l'Universiade de Taipei 2017, le maire de Taipei, Monsieur Ke Wen-je, ainsi que le président de la Fédération internationale du sport universitaire, Monsieur Oleg Mathiesen.
Chen Fu-Zong-Tong, Mathiesen 会长, 意大利拿破里市代表,
各位选手与队职员，在座的嘉宾，全球的观众朋友，大家晚安。我是台北市长柯文哲，让台北的夏天更加多彩多姿。
To the MSA, thank you for making it such a memorable summer for all of us. It has been a privilege for our 23 million citizens to witness you write this chapter of history and create these wonderful memories with you. Once again, we thank the world for joining us here. Thank you.
And as the athletes prepare to go home, I know that we'll take a part of Taipei with them. I know this city and these people will have a special place in their hearts for the years to come. It is 6 years since FISU awarded the hosting of this universe to Taipei. And after 6 years of hard work, Taipei has given many of these athletes the best moments in their lives. To the spectators of the last days, to the volunteers of last days, I must say, xie xie. And with that, let me hereby declare the Taipei 2017 Summer Universiade officially closed. Thank you very much.
And with that, it was time for the lowering of the FISU flag, as the mayor of Taipei and FISU president handed it off to the next host city of the Summer Universiade, Naples, Italy.
Tout de suite, la cérémonie de passation de drapeau entre les comités d'organisation des villes hautes de l'Universiade.
请本届执行委员会主任委员台北市市长柯文熙先生进行挥旗。 First Mayor of Taipei, Mr. Ke Wen-je, please wave the flag. Next, the FISU President, Mr. Oleg Matitsin. Of the National University Sports Federation of Italy, CUSI, Mr. Lorenzo Lentini. Next, President of Naples 2019 Universiade Organizing Committee, Mr. Raimondo Pasquino.
Ladies and gentlemen, the 29th Summer Universiade 2017 Taipei has now been concluded. The FISU flag is now handed over to the next host city.
Prima di tutto, ringrazio il comitato organizzatore di Taipei.
First of all, I would like to thank the Taipei Organizing Committee for the great universiade we have had here and for their very warm hospitality.
Degna di una grande tradizione. Molto presto,
very soon, the testimonial of the universiade will run with us to Naples.
Per la trentesima edizione,
the 30th edition of Universiade with the brand of Naples
Napoli
will be under the symbol of Vesuvian,
del simbolo del Vesuvio, e sarà
an event of both culture and sport,
di sport,
as you have seen
cultura,
in our official video.
Così come vedrete nel nostro video ufficiale. Vi aspettiamo tutti a Napoli. Grazie a tutti.
Looking forward to seeing you in Naples.
Forza Napoli!
Thank you, Taiwan. Thank you, Taipei.
Voglio innanzitutto esprimere il mio saluto
first of all,
a
Sua Eccellenza my gratitude to the Vice President Chen Chen-jen,
al Presidente della FISU Oleg Martysyn,
the Chairperson of the Executive Committee of Taipei Summer Universiade, Mayor Ko,
a tutte le autorità sportive civili,
athletes,
agli atleti, ai volontari, a tutti i presenti. Vi aspettiamo tutti. Viva Taipei, viva
we
l'Italia.
Wait for you in Naples. Viva Taipei, viva Italy.
Now a performance that pays homage to Naples. The city is known for its rich traditions and for the San Carlo Theater. The international ambassador of the Parthenopean and regional culture kicks off a performance that has never been seen before, which recalls typical Neapolitan culture. Two dancers then took to the stage with tambourines in their hands. They wore traditional 18th century costumes, giving expression to accents of this popular Naples music. Classic techniques and modern virtues were at the root of this San Carlo dancer's performance, which represents Coriutica, the oldest theater in Europe, which was founded in 1812 in the first dance school in Italy. And then melodies of traditional Taiwanese popcorn music symbolize the final act of the closing ceremonies. A union of East and West is symbolized through the playing of traditional Chinese Suna, a reference to the trumpets of ancient Greek Olympics. Harmony between all Taiwanese and the world is reflected in a musical marriage of popcorn, jazz saxophone, rock and roll, local indigenous elements, and a symphony of Chinese orchestra. Ceremony, audiences saw the torch relay come to an end by lighting the cauldron. So during the closing ceremony here, the cauldron is extinguished as the fire makes its way to Naples, Italy for the 2019 Summer Universiade. With the fireworks show set to begin, it's the song The Moment, with arrangement and production by Baby C, that fills the air. Just like that, the closing ceremony concludes and the 29th Summer Universiade is over. The games were a huge success, not only for the athletes who participated, but for FISU, for the organizing committee, for the city of Taipei, the volunteers, the fans, and everyone who tuned in and cheered on their favorite sports from around the world. From everyone here at FISU, thank you to the people of Chinese Taipei, and we'll see you in Naples in 2019.